Addition polymerization. Same or different unsaturated monomers when simply get linked together to form a polymer, it is called addition polymerization. This mode of polymerization can take place through formation of either free radicals or some ionic species, example carbocation or carbanion. Addition polymerization is also called chain growth polymerization because the polymer chain grows in stages by addition of one molecule of monomer at a time, and each stage produces reactive intermediate for use in the next stage of growth of the chain. We discuss below different modes of addition polymerization. 1. Free radical, addition, polymerization. A variety of unsaturated compounds, example alkenes, dienes, or their derivatives polymerize through the formation of free radicals. So, it is called free radical addition polymerization. The polymerization is initiated by initiator molecule which readily decompose to form free radical. The free radical adds to a monomer molecule to form a new free radical of larger size. Subsequently it adds to the double bond of second molecule of monomer, generating still larger free radical. Repetition of this event ultimately yields polymer. A. Vinyl polymerization. Most of the commercial polymers are vinyl polymers obtained from alkenes and their derivatives of type CH2 equals CHG. Where G equals H, Cl, CH2 Cl, Cn, CH3 etc. The polymerization is carried out by heating the monomer with only a very small amount of initiator or by exposing the monomer to light. The initiator generates free radical. It can be organic peroxide like benzoyl peroxide, T-butyl peroxide, or another reagent. In this reaction alkyl free radical is formed. In this reaction T-butoxide free radical is formed. In this reaction carboxyl radical and phenyl free radical are formed. The free radicals carry out the polymerization in following steps. 1. Chain initiation step. The free radical, R, formed from initiator adds to alkene double bond, generating a new radical. 2. Chain propagation step. The new free radical so formed adds to second molecule of monomer, forming a larger free radical. The repetition of this step with new and bigger radicals propagates the reaction and cause polymer chain growth. 3. Chain termination step. Ultimately at the end the product radical formed reacts with another radical to form the product. Other compounds present in the reaction mixture, example amines, phenols, quinones etc. act as inhibitors of polymerization. Growing free radicals in second chain propagation step may get involved in side reactions with some other compounds called chain transfer agents. Example CCl4, CBr4. So, the chain growth is interrupted. The product of such a reaction may initiate its own chain growth. Such reagents are called chain transfer agents. Example CCl4, CBr4 etc. The mode of interference of chain transfer agents can be shown as under. The formation of polystyrene free radical in absence of chain transfer agent is as shown above. In presence of CCl4 the chain reaction is halted as shown below. The new CCl3 free radical formed initiates its own chain reaction as shown below. This is the side chain reaction of polystyrene polymerization. If the chain transfer agent forms highly unreactive radical the chain gets terminated. B. Conjugated diene polymerization. A conjugated diene like 1,3-butadiene can be polymerized like a simple alkene, but there are two modes by which this process can take place. 1,1,4 polymerization, a linear polymer is formed when polymerization takes place at C1 and C4 of butadiene. The polymer can exist either as transpolybutadiene or cispolybutadiene or as a mixture as shown below. 2,1,2 polymerization. Alternatively, 1,3-butadiene can undergo polymerization at C1 and C2 to yield polyvinyl polythene. The double bonds in these initial polymers can be linked by further treatment with chemicals to modify the properties of polymer. 2. Ionic addition polymerization. Vinylic monomers can undergo addition polymerization through the formation of ionic intermediates. The initiator used in the reaction acts as an ion, anion or cation, source. The general modes of both these ionic polymerizations are discussed below. A. Cationic addition polymerization. When the initiator is cationic in nature and addition is propagated by a cationic intermediate, it is called cationic addition polymerization. The process is initiated by an acid. In the chain initiation step, the proton, H+, adds on at the double bond to form a cation. On further addition to the double bond yields a bigger cation. This sequence of steps propagates the chain growth. The chain termination can take place by loss of the proton. The presence of electron-releasing groups in the monomers facilitate cationic polymerization. Thus, isobutylene with two electrons releasing, CH3 groups undergo cationic addition polymerization easily. The steps can be illustrated as under. 1. Chain initiation step. The methyl groups favor formation of carbocation and stabilize it. 2. Chain propagating step. This is a recurring event. 3. Chain terminating step. In many industrial processes, boron trifluoride, Lewis acid, and water, co-catalyst, is used to induce cationic polymerization. BF3 reacts with water to give a very strong Bronsted acid, HBF3O, which initiates polymerization. B. Anionic addition polymerization. An anionic initiator will generate carbanionic intermediates which propagate polymerization. The active center of the propagating species is negatively charged, hence, electron withdrawing groups in the monomer stabilize the propagating species to continue polymerization. Example: the formation of polystyrene in presence of potassium amide follows anion addition polymerization. It can be depicted as under. 1. Chain initiation step. Initiation can be brought about by reagents such as N-butyl lithium or potassium amide. In the initiation step, the base adds to the double bond to form a carbanion. The phenyl group, PH(C6H5), is an electron withdrawing group, so stabilizes carbanion species. 2. Chain propagating step. In chain propagation, carbanion adds to the double bond and the events repeat to form the polymer. 3. Chain terminating step. Termination occurs by addition of an acid, H, and proton. 3. Ziegler-Natta polymerization. It is addition polymerization carried out in presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst. The catalyst is an extremely complex and reactive solid consisting of titanium tetra, or tri, chloride and an alkyl aluminium compound, Let3ClTicl4. Most commonly it is obtained by adding a solution of TiCl4, titanium tetrachloride, to a solution of C2H5(3-altriethylaluminium) in an inert solvent like heptane. The important characters of Ziegler-Natta catalysts include: polymer chain grows linearly due to head-to-tail linkage. Polymerization occurs under relatively mild conditions of temperature, 313 to 353 K, and pressure, 1 to 25x 101.3 kPa. Polymers with favorable stereochemistry can be made. The process permits a considerable degree of stereochemical control over the way in which the monomer units enter the polymer chain. The mechanism of action of Ziegler-Natta catalysts is not yet clear. But it appears that there is exchange of halogen atoms and alkyl groups resulting in the formation of a substance containing titanium alkyl bonds. The monomer then undergoes insertion between the titanium and the alkyl group by coordination with titanium through pi bonding. The polymer chain grows with successive insertion of monomer into the bond between the metal and the growing chain. The events are depicted below in much simplified way to help understanding. The exchange of chlorine and ethyl group is shown in below reaction. Insertion of monomer takes place by the following mechanism. This insertion takes place continuously till the average length polymer is formed. A chiral monomers may polymerize to generate stereoenters. Thus, three different types of head-to-tail polymers are possible in vinyl polymerization. Isotactic. The stereochemistry along a polymer chain is called isotactic when all the X-substituted carbon atoms have identical configuration. Syndiotactic, the configuration around X substituted carbon alternates between R and S configuration. Atactic, the configuration around X substituted carbon bear no regularity in stereochemistry. Only isotactic and syndiotactic polymers have the crystallinity that imparts high melting point and mechanical strength required in a polymer.